It's more of a mental sport than it is of a physical sport.
And the championship leader is in the wall.
Let me do it, man. I'm trying my best.
Come on!
And in motorsports, you lose more than you win.
I'm out. Sorry, guys.
We have our egos, and we think, like, if we win a race tomorrow, you know, the whole world is on their knees for us.
Formula E has returned to Brooklyn for its second race of the weekend. This is round 11 of 15, the New York City E-Prix.
We're without an American driver in Formula E at the moment. We have had them in the past, but not just now. But we do have American teams, and New York City is really the home race for Dragon Penske Autosport.
I won't lie, it is an important race for me. And I don't know, somehow I look at this track and I feel like we can go faster on here. I hope I'm right. It's such a special type of racecraft involved in Formula E. You gotta keep that steady level of concentration. You gotta keep it the whole time because it's so intense. Those 45 minutes, they seem like much more than 45 minutes.
Sette Camara wrestling with the car right up to the wall.
The feeling, the adrenaline never changes. When you get close to the wall at 200, it's addicting. I really like that. On top of that, it's like you're in a phone call with your engineer the whole time. So you're multitasking the whole time because every lap, you gotta give some values to your engineer that he knows how much energy you have left. Then he gives that information back to you while racing, while avoiding walls, while trying to go as fast as you can. So in the end of those 45 minutes, you're like, man, I need to take, you know, some air.
As a person, friendly, a real family guy. I think he's still probably finding his feet in the paddock in terms of, you know, what social group he's in.
I've got two drivers which speak Portuguese, one of them being Brazilian. Lucas is a great friend of mine. And then we have Antonio as well, such a nice guy. Both of them have given me advice and been so supportive.
Hey, man.
Como é que tá, fi?
Bom? Tá bom já aqui? Foi aqui? Tá bom?
Ah, já tá bom. O braço ainda dói um pouquinho.
Dói?
Mas o corpo já tá bom.
Pô. Sim.
Nossa, eu tomei vacina, fiquei 2 dias de cama, velho. Meu preparo deve estar uma bosta.
Ficou cama mesmo?
É, fiquei morto.
Sério?
O ano passado você foi bem pra caralho aqui. Eu tava vendo o footage lá da Prêmio Corrida 1.
Sim.
Você saiu lá do meio do pelotão e veio, que terminou lá na frente, terceiro, né?
Sim. E o vosso carro novo, que tal? Bom?
Cara, melhor, mas eu tô errando, velho.
Tem que acertar e tal. É normal, as nossas duas primeiras corridas com o carro novo foram difíceis também. Sorry.
Don't get distracted, man.
I always get distracted. You're lucky, I only said hello to one. Wanted to say hello to all of them.
Yeah, this is my first full season in Formula E. I would say 100% it's more of a mental sport than it is of a physical sport. Of course, you need a certain physical level to drive the car. And then you need another physical level, which is even higher, to drive the car without, you know, being tired. But once you reach that, there's not much to gain from it. What you really gain is with the mental side.
You know, I've had a mental coach when I was a little bit younger, and I learned a lot from this guy. You know, my first approach is, man, why do I need to go to a psychologist? You know, my head's super good, I'm not crazy. And it was the best thing I've done, you know, away from my racing. Sometimes you cannot control anxieties or stress levels, or you're putting pressure on yourself for this or that. It's just not controllable, you know, like that. If that pressure is there, okay, how can I deal with it? You know, so you just understand yourself a lot more. So I learned a lot, and now I've been doing the same lately with a Portuguese guy, very, very good. He works with a lot of athletes. I remember calling him on the Monaco week saying, man, I don't know why, but the amount of pressure I'm putting on myself to win this weekend on the Tuesday, it's, man, I'm not even in Monaco yet, and I can't sleep. And you know, he walked me through a lot of tricks and ways to deal with that and everything. And man, you know, to pull off the Monaco weekend with a pole position and a victory, you know, and a lot of that is thanks to this guy.
Winning a race starts before the race weekend by being, you know, good in your mind, good in yourself, good with your friends, your family, with your team, having done your work properly, coming in, you know, in peace with yourself at the track, and just, yeah, you know, to have fun and deliver what you know best.
I've had periods of times, almost of sometimes a year, where you don't do well. And in motorsports, you lose more than you win, because you have 24 people racing and only one will win. And you know, you just got to keep focusing on your work. Don't let the results get to you. That's what I do, and it's so hard to do because your mind naturally looks towards results and it bases all of your actions, right or wrong, on results. But it's not how things should be done.
Racing drivers or athletes, you know, we have our egos, and we think like if we win a race tomorrow, you know, the whole world is on their knees for us or whatever, you know, like, and that's not the case. So it's very easy for a pro athlete to lose sight of things, and so we become spoiled babies sometimes, and we all, you know, get carried away, and so it's important to manage that side of things as well.
What do you fear? You fear things that you don't understand or that you don't control. Well, you fear that you're gonna start at the back, don't fear it, you know, embrace it. Just focus on the things that you can control. And I think when you do that, you don't have many fears.
So after finishing second in yesterday's race, Jean-Éric Vergne starts at the very back of the grid. Antonio Felix da Costa starts in seventh. Just ahead of him in sixth is Sergio Sette Camara.
Let's do this.
Two attack modes, right? Let's do it.
And it's a front row lockout for Jaguar Racing. Mitch Evans second on the grid, Sam Bird on pole position. All five lights are on and we go green in New York City. Good start from Bird, but it's a better start from Cassidy. Evans locks up, he somehow holds on to second position. Sergio Sette Camara is in fourth position. Da Costa is up into sixth place. Jean-Éric Vergne hasn't got off the line.
Stuck and I'm in the middle of the racing line.
Zara and Dennis are having a crunch there, coming down into seventh, and the championship leader is in the wall. Sergio Sette Camara gets through and gets ahead of Alexander Sims. Bird activates attack mode, and then he's let back through by Mitch Evans. There goes Sims, finally making the move on Sergio Sette Camara.
I think I have a flat tire. I think it's f***ed. He's gone. Oh, man!
Just keep going. We've got two more laps. See what you can do.
Here comes Nick Cassidy now on the attack for second place. The Jaguar of Evans covers the inside. He's starting to go defensive. Is Da Costa going to take advantage of this?
You get him. He's over consuming.
Let me do it, man. I'm trying my best.
Come on!
Attack now.
And here it is. What's happened to Mitch Evans?
I'm out. Sorry, guys.
A lights-to-flag victory for Sam Bird through the final corner. Checkered flag falls. Sam Bird and Jaguar win in New York City and take the lead of the championship.
Yes! You the man, Sam. You owned that race. Nice one.
Sam Bird wins for the second time this season, finishing 4 seconds clear of Nick Cassidy for the Envision Virgin Racing team. Antonio Felix da Costa finishes third for the DS Techeetah squad.
Yeah, happy with that.
Tees things up nicely for London.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'll worry about London a bit later. Just enjoy this one for now.
Da Costa's teammate Jean-Éric Vergne failed to get off the line and finished in last place. And after starting in an impressive sixth, a flat tyre saw Sergio Sette Camara drop down the order to finish just outside of the points in 11th.
I can't f***ing believe this, James. Ah! I can't believe it, man. The tyre, I'm sure this tyre has a bung. Ah, man!
Understood, buddy. It was a pretty good effort until then. Unlucky, man.
But what a day today. I think that's 29 points out of a possible 30. Couldn't be more happy.
The championship leader in the pits.
Retiring the car. Jump out.
What a stupid decision to fight him.
They race like bumper cars.
Push.
I think we should do it.
That's how you race formally.
I just put myself and my son in this position and you feel so sad just because you cannot do anything about it.
Subscribe to the Formula E YouTube channel for more.